channel or welcome back. My name is Abby, otherwise known as Skinny Pigs One. I make guinea pig related videos every Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday. So please subscribe so you don't miss out. Today's topic is on a controversial one about why I don't feel you should ask for a medical emergency advice in regards to your small pets online. So this isn't directed towards any one person. I see it all over across YouTube, questions getting asked that are better suited towards your vet. So number one reason is you're gonna get a delayed response. If you're having an emergency in a crisis, waiting for somebody to answer you online, I'm going to say is fairly pointless, because even if you do get a response, it could be incorrect. It could be so delayed that something's happened to your pig in the meantime. And even if you get a correct response, say they guess right, you're still no further ahead to getting your guinea pig help. So delayed responses, you don't know if somebody's at work, sleeping, out partying, so you could just be waiting around and around forever. Maybe they won't even see your comment, and you're waiting and waiting on somebody who in reality cannot help you. In less than 12 hours, a guinea pig can pass away from serious medical complications, say from bloat, from stasis happening. So time is of the essence. Another thing to remember is, by the time we notice our guinea pig is ill, they've been hiding things for a while. It's their natural instinct, survival of the fittest, to hide their illness for as long as they possibly can. They want to appear as strong as they can for as long as they can. So if they're showing us a bunch of signs or symptoms, they've been sick for a while. So another reason is, if you do ask for help and say somebody gets back to you right away, it could be incorrect or damaging, unsafe information, advice. So you could say, hey, my guinea pig's been sneezing all day. Do you think this is a problem? Somebody could message you back saying, hey, my guinea pig did that for a few weeks and it went away. It was no big deal. So you could be thinking, oh, okay, I'll just leave it. And it actually could be a life-threatening upper respiratory infection or pneumonia that you chose to leave because somebody else chimed in with their advice. So it's definitely just best to cut out the middleman, so like a pet tuber, and go right to your vet. So instead of messaging us or leaving a comment of the signs and symptoms your pig has, call your vet and share that with them and bring your pet in to get seen by them. Do you see what I'm kind of saying? Like this just, you're just kind of wasting, sadly, time typing it out to somebody who can't help you. So for myself, even if I think I know what's wrong with your pet, I'm going to say take them to the vet. Because there's honestly, even if I'm correct, you're no further ahead with getting your help. Because I can't properly diagnose, I can't give out medications, I can't see your pig physically to even know what's going on. So you need to go to the trained professional, people who help the guinea pigs, the veterinarians. So generally speaking, I think the absolute best policy is to go with your gut instincts. You see your guinea pigs every day, you get used to their routine, their personalities, how they respond to you. So if one of them seems off, the chances are something is wrong. So go to your vet for a health check. Worst case scenario, they're perfectly healthy. And I think the price you paid for the appointment is worth the peace of mind. We've all been there, we've taken our pig to the vet and nothing's wrong, but more often than not, something was. So if you get used to your guinea pig's routine, how they respond to you and react to you every day, and one of them is being off, take them to the vet. So an example for me would be in the morning when I come down, everybody's at the bars for their tomato. And if somebody's staying in bed versus coming up to the bars, that's a red flag to me that what's wrong with that piggy? Why are they not coming out? Another thing I could advise you on is do some reading on trusted sites. So I'm gonna say GuineaLinks. They have all the most common medical issues that guinea pigs can have, how they get diagnosed, how they get treated, what signs and symptoms there are. So you could read up on all of that so that you have a book of knowledge in your head to pick out, hey, my guinea pig's peeing blood, they're crying when they're peeing, I'm going to take them to the vet because that's signs of a UTI. So that you don't even have to ask anybody else, you already know it in your head, and you're going to go take your guinea pig to the vet to say like, hey, this and this is happening, I think maybe they have this wrong, and they'll do the tests, they'll give you the treatments, It's a lot of stress asking people online because then you're sitting on pins and needles waiting for somebody to respond to you. I 100% respect that people are looking for comfort. So it's absolutely okay to ask for advice or what have you after your guinea pig's already receiving their treatment. So you could say, hey, how long did it take your pig to get over this? What kind of antibiotics were you given? Or did you give a probiotic? How do you syringe them properly? I'm having troubles. Things like that, I'm absolutely fine with discussing with people. It's the initial diagnosis that I'm not okay with because I don't want people to think they can replace seeing a vet by asking me, because I am not a replacement for a vet. I'm not a replacement for anyone. I'm just a girl sitting on the other side of a camera sharing my life with my guinea pigs and things I've learned as I've gone along. I don't have all the answers. I learn new things all the time. I go through my own medical issues with my pigs. Do I share experiences with the medical issues? Absolutely, because I want to promote that going to the vet is important, that giving medications to them when needed is important. I like sharing what symptoms I notice, so if other people notice them, they can pick up on them quicker and get their pig help quicker. I share the medical side of things because I want to inspire others to take their guinea pigs to the vet, because that's something that still is really taboo. A lot of people think they're only worth $20. Why are you spending $200+ on them? They're life, they're important, and time is of the essence. So when it comes to emergency medical help, I plead for you to just pick up the phone and call your vet and share what's happening with your vet so you can get in and get seen. And a super important thing is, not only do you need to have a vet, but please look into getting an after-hours vet. So for myself, my vet clinic closes at about 6 o'clock at night. So I need a place for after hours during the nights or during holidays where I can call and take my pigs if something were to happen. And even if that means driving a few hours, it's still important to have that backup vet. When I first had guinea pigs, I've been there where you're in a panic of thinking, okay, is this something wrong with them or is it not? Like, I don't know. Where do I go? Where do I call? And you're Googling vets and then you're calling places and they're like, we don't see guinea pigs. So this is something that's super important to do before you get pigs, or if you just got pigs, or maybe you've had pigs for a few years and haven't had to go to the vet. Still, please go search for that vet that's knowledgeable, that you like, that's safe, that's trusted. Get their number, put it on your fridge, so whenever something does happen, that panic portion of it can be taken away and you know your game plan. You know who you're going to call, where you're going to go. Because that's another thing. If you're going to a new place, you might have to put that in your GPS. You might get lost. So it's important to be set. So I think that's all I wanted to say. And again, this is not pointing fingers at anybody. We've all been there where we've asked questions that we should have just asked our vet instead. It happens. I just want to really emphasize how important it is to get your guinea pig the help that they need in a timely fashion, and to not put the weight of the signs and symptoms on other people, and to not have unrealistic expectations that somebody's going to be able to help you over the internet, when in reality that they sadly can't. If we could, we would, but we can't. So anyways, guys, I will talk to you later, and you can leave your comments down below. Bye-bye.